Hello everyone, this is Mena from Civil Center and I welcome all of you back to the third episode of the 1300 square feet building design in Techlash Tech Solution. So in this three episodes we have covered the entire design. So if you haven't watched the previous two episodes, I'll give the link in the description in the second or third line. You can check out that and watch the full episode. So in today's part we'll do the loading, and in the previous parts we had seeing how from an architectural plan we can make the center line diagram, place the columns, and then make and import the center line in the Techlash Texture Designer. And in the second video, in the second part, we had discussed about in detail about the modeling part and the process to do the modeling in a way so that you don't have any errors. So in today's video we'll talk about the loadings. So we'll discuss some concepts also and also how to apply it in very simple. I don't think it will be a long video, so let's get started. So first of all, we'll go to our plinth level, which we have already made, and you can go to the plinth level from here, or you can go to this option of structure and then levels, and you can just click on the plinth level which you have named. So here we have our 10 inch walls and the 5 inch walls. All the external walls will give the external wall loading, and all the internal walls will give the loading of the internal walls. Now, so the loads depends on the code. In this case we are using IS code, so the dead load is defined by IS 875 part 1. So this actually will vary based on the masonry material which you are using. I have taken SSC blocks here. If you are taking red clay bricks, the weight will be significantly larger, around 18 or 19. So the unit of masonry is this, and the unit weight of mortar is written it wrong. It will be around 20 kilonewton per meter cube for the mortar. And the height of the brick wall, the floor to floor height is 3.2 meters, and the minimum width of the roof beams by experience is 0.3 meter. It can be 0.35, can 0.4, so we can, if this value can reduce, but anyway this will be on the safer side because 0.3 is minimum for all the roof beams in case of depth. So that, so the calculation is pretty simple. You have the thickness defined for the 10 inch walls. So basically for the 10 inch wall, 1 inch can be taken as your plaster or mortar, and the 9 inch can be taken as a bricks. It is generally the convention. It also depends on your brick sizes available. I have taken 9 inch brick sizes here available, and if there are 9 inch brick sizes available, then there will be 1 inch plaster. So 9 inch means your 0.225 mm, and the load calculation will be the unit weight multiplied by the height multiplied by the thickness. So this is the unit weight is coming, and the thickness of the mortar is 0.025 mm, sorry, meter, and this will be unit weight multiplied by the height multiplied by the total thickness. So it will be this value. So if you add this two value, that is the load of the mortar and the brick wall, plaster plus brick, it will be 6.05. So similarly for the 5 inch wall, it is done here for this particular inner walls. And if you were to calculate for the parapet walls, and parapet walls are actually, they are, actually 10 inch thickness given normally, and 10 inch thickness parapet wall, the height of the parapet wall is 1 meter. Why 10 inch is given? It is given for a safety in general terms, and the height is 1 meter, it's around 3 feet 3 inches. So I'm just also going to write here 1 meter to avoid any confusion. So the thickness of the brick wall here will be same, and only the height will change here. So in the case of the 2.9 meter, we're going to use here 1 meter, and here also, you'll also use this 1 meter. So this value will just calculate here, 7 into 1 into 0.225 equals to 1.575. So just calculate this 1.575, and or rather you can just take 1.58, or here it will, the value will be 20 into 0.025, it will be 0.5. so 0.5, so if you just add these two values, it will be around 1.58 plus 0.5. so using this method, you can calculate the load for your red bricks or fly ash bricks as well. Just you need the unit weight and the thickness of the wall. If it varies, you can change that. So in our case, we have this load. This is the load for the parapet wall. You can make it bold here, and this is the load for your 5 inch wall, so the inner walls. This is the load for the 10-inch one. So we've calculated these loads and you can use this in our software. And for the live load, we are using IS 875 part 2. And as per the IS 875 part 2 table number 1, we have the loads defined for the different, you know, usage. If you are using Euro codes, it can be different. So according to the Indian code, for the residential building, we have 2 kN per meter square load which has to be applied, and we'll apply that. So these are the values which we'll take into consideration, and if you're using a different code, you have to take into consideration of that different, Euro code or VS code or US code, whichever code you are using. So I'm going to apply the load simply. So first of all, the load will be applied as a form of UDL. So go to load here and just take this option of fitted load, which is by default there. Go to full UDL and we'll just select the value from here. So first of all, I'll apply the load of the 10 inch walls. It is 6.05. So I'll just go do here 6.05 kilonewton per meter, meters per meter actually. So we'll just apply for the 10 inch wall here. So this is kind of a garage. So this will be 10 inch wall here, and along the staircase all the walls are generally 10 inches. So I'll apply this 10 inches load, and along all the outer walls I'll apply the 10 inches load. So it basically depends on where the 10 inch wall is. So this is portico, so these two sides will be open, so you don't need to apply here. And the remaining load for the 5 inch wall is 3.48. so just apply, take here 3.48 and just click and apply the loads here. And once these loads are applied, you can see here the and check how the loads are applied. So we'll go to structure 3D and we'll just click on this dead load, and you can see this portion of the dead load which has been applied. So now, before I'll just check the beam dimensions here. So it is 356 which is given. So for the next floor, I'll just go here. You can go to the structure one, or you can just select, double click on here also. Both the ways you can go. And first of all, I'll go and apply the dead load here. Please note that this is the plinth level, and the sand filling will be done here, and after that the PCC will be done here. So there will be no slab here, and therefore no imposed load. So in this floor, there will be your slab, your dead load, as well as the imposed load. So we'll just apply the dead load. So the dead is selected, and after that you go to full UDL, and this time we'll apply the 10 inch wall load first. So the 10 inch wall load, again you can see 6.05. so we'll just go 6.05 and apply the load of the 10 inch walls. And some people always, even in the top floor they apply the 5 inch wall. So it depends basically on the user requirement, what the user wants. So around the staircase I'm going to apply the 10 inch wall load, and along the interior I'm going to apply 3.48, that is my load for our internal walls. So we are making this video, every part you can see in this video is every detail, everything has been covered. So if you just like our effort, make sure you hit the like button because it makes the YouTube happy. So here just dead load is applied. You can just check the dead loads which has been applied here. Zoom in and you can check the dead loads which has been applied. Now time for the live loads. So for the live load, go to imposed here and go to this option of level here and just apply this load of 2 and apply it like this. So it is applied like this, the live load, and go to structure 3D, and you can also check the dead load as well as this imposed loads. So as you can see, once you can see this, you can go to the top floor. Just click on this structure 2, this is the topmost floor, and in this top floor we are going to go to this option of load and this option of your dead load, and click the full UDL, and here just apply the load of the 10 inch walls here on this portion of our headroom. So this is 6.05, it will be basically a little bit less because the headroom height is less, but I'm just taking it, it will be just for the purpose of safety. I'm just taking this particular load, and load for the parapet wall is your 2.08, which we have calculated. It will be 2.08, and here I'm going to apply this load along the perimeter of the terrace, and you can just see this happening here like this. So nicely it calibrates. You can just use the right click and hold it for the rotating the model. nicely calibrated, so the larger load has been showed with a larger magnitude. So like this it is done, and now let's go to the imposed loads here, and we'll just apply the imposed loads as per just go to this level load and 2 kN/m² for our residential building. Just click on here, the imposed load will be applied. This is the imposed load and this is the dead load. So we have forgot to apply the slab here, so we go to the topmost level and we'll just click on the model and the slab on beams, and this is probably one way slab. We'll just check here which slab it is. We'll just go to measure and this value is 2.108, so this value is 4.521. so 4.5 divided by 2.1, it is 2.14, so this is a one way slab. So just gonna go slab here and just click on this slab, and in this slab just click on the new slab, and reinforcement will be one way, 100 mm is the depth which has been selected. So this is the slab type and which has been applied. So there will be no loads here, only the self weight will be there, and because there will be only the headroom roof, so there will be no other loads which has been applied. So we applied the dead load and also the imposed loads. So now we can apply the other loads, but since this is a two floor building, so as per the Indian code for the wind load, you don't need to apply wind load for buildings up to 10 meter height, so you don't have to apply that. And also as per IS, that is the seismic code for detailing, IS 1392, so that seismic code for detailing tells us that out to four floors we don't need to apply seismic load. If it is lying at a zone 3, up to zone 3 we don't need to apply that. If you have more than zone 3, then we may need to apply that particular thing. So we'll not apply that particular seismic load here, because only in special cases, only if you have more than zone 4 in the low rise buildings, then only zone 4 or zone 5 as per the Indian standards, then only you have to apply the seismic load. So now once you have done this, and if you want to know how to apply the seismic loads, we have lots of video on that, you can check that out. So after that, you just can validate the model, just to check whether everything is okay. And once you know everything is okay, just go to design, and before going to design, go to load and go to load combination and click on generate. So it will generate the load combination as per the codes you have selected. Then you just need to click on next, and this is option, because in Indian codes we have two methods, limit state method and working stress method. So we are preferring the limit state method, it is more economical. So just click on next and then finish, and after that you just click on OK, and after that go to design and then design all static. So it will take some time, but it will give your results. So as you can see, the model has been designed, and if you just turn off this load, you can see that almost all the columns are passed, and you can just check the design. Let's see whether it's visible or not, and check number static, and it's four bars of 16 mm. Check out the review, and you can check out the ratio as well. And here the ratio as well, you can see that it is pretty much decent. As you can see, we told that this column is at larger spacing, this column is also being passed at 3UT16. So the members which you provided, they are okay. And there are some warnings in the plinth beam. There is also always a warning of the axial force which has to be negated, but overall the structure has been designed. And if you want to design the foundations here, you can also design the foundation here as well. For that, you just need to go to the foundation and click on the pad base column. Just select this, and before selecting this, just one thing you might need to consider is that the unit weight of soil and the allowable bearing capacity. So it will give this as per the soil test report. If it is not available, just Google it and make sure, or from other reliable sources you can see the range of the soil bearing capacity. As per that you can provide it, and after that you can just click on this and click on design pad bases. The pad bases will be designed. So once the pad bases will be designed, your design should be ready, and after that you need to extract the drawings from this. So we'll make a video on how to extract the drawings and how to generate the reports in this software. So that's all for today. Thanks for watching the video. Bye bye.